मुखम करोति वाचालम पंगुम लंघायति गिरी जत कृपा तमहं वंदे श्री गुरुदिन तारिणम ओम ज्ञान तिमिरंधस्य ज्ञानंजन शलाकया चक्षुर्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति सरुदमदर स्वामिति नामिने नमो सद्भक्त मने मणिपुर भवे च प्रभुपादलस्य देवाणी प्रचार निरतायते पूज्य श्री गुरुवर्ग वंदित महाभावान्वित सदा पूर्वापर्य परंपरा प्रचलित प्राच्य प्रमुखकिते भक्तिर निर्मल निर्जरस निवृतम समरककम सादरम वंदे श्री गुरुदेव नाथ शिलाचार्य वर्जम निजम गुरुवाविष्ट सुप्रकम गुरुगणैराशिष संभूषितम चिंता चिंत समस्त वेद निपुणम श्रीरूप पंथानुगम गोविंदविदम उज्ज्वलम भरतनुम भक्तान्वितम सुंदरम वंदे विश्व गुरुम च दिव्य भगवत प्रेम्नो हि बीजप्रदम। अथ नत्वा मंत्र गुरुन गुरुन भागवतार्थदान व्यासान जगत गुरु नत्वा तत जय मुदिरे। वृंदाये तुलसी देव्याय प्रियाय केशवस्य च कृष्ण भक्ति पदे देवी सत्यवते नमः नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवा सादि श्री गौर भक्तबिंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। Dandavat pranam to all the devotees. By the grace of our Guru Bhargava, we are trying to humbly do some service to remember their teaching by your all good association. So Dandavat to Sumangala Didi, Raghumai Didi, Dandavat. So today Dandavat. we are wanted to discuss it topic, the standard to measure human life. So there is a flyer that Sripad Bhakti Madhava Puri Maharaj prepared some time back for our Sri Chaitanya Saraswat Mutt, and it is published on our website, Mutt website, long back. With this flyer that Sripad Bhakti Madhava Puri Maharaj prepared for distribution. And from there, it's a short write-up that we would like to read. All glories to Sri Guru and Sri Gauranga, the standard to measure human life by Sripad Bhakti Madhava Puri Maharaj, USA, for Sri Chaitanya Saraswat Mutt, Kolerganj, Navadip. Everything has its standard by which it is to be measured. If you want to measure space or distance, a standard unit of measure is required. But what is that standard? And by what unit can the standard be measured? Of course, the standard itself cannot be measured by any other unit, or that would become the standard. So standard must be absolute. It cannot be measured by anything else. Rather, everything is measured by it. This is the nature of the absolute God, the ideal, against which all reality is measured. Do you all know about the standard, how they fix the meter, kilogram, all these things? Anybody knows? Anybody has any idea? How they know? What is 1 meter? What is 1 kilogram? Anybody knows? Anybody heard about it? How they decide what is 1 meter, what is 1 kilogram? Yes, how they measure it? How they know?
Kilogram is, if 1,000 gram, it is 1 kilogram. And
that is not how they know. How they know that that is 1 meter. What is that is 1 kilogram.
This is some standard unit.
They kept a rod somewhere in some museum. This they accepted as 1 meter. There is the first measuring from there, and they kept a some metal, you know, object. And they say, this is what, you know, 1 kilogram is. Based on that, they're measuring everything else. The kilogram, meter, and everything. That cannot be measured because that is the standard. From there, everything is coming. They are thinking how to preserve that 1 meter because it is degrading, you know, that material. 1 kilogram is degrading, all these things. They are, you know, doing that thing. There are so many research and on that is going on. But here, Sipat Puri Maharaj, he made a flyer about the standard of human life. And Maharaj is explaining the God, the ideal against which reality is measured. First, the reality, it cannot be the morality or anything that we are, you know, trying to understand. That is, you know, the measure is God. But what about a human being? Let us read further. It is in that existence which is measured by that ideal, the reality is to be found. And where do we find such an existence? It cannot be found in any natural thing or ordinary person. It is only in the personality of the Vaishnava, whose life, movement, and being is measured by that standard. Such a Vaishnava is the standard by which all human life is to be measured. So, Sipat Puri Maharaj is saying, Vaishnava is the standard. A pure Vaishnava, from that we can measure the, you know, standard of human life. How much human life is in line with that you know, level of that standard of living. From there we can measure. But modern society does not know this standard. And therefore, there is so much fighting and bewilderment. They have standards for everything else. A standard for the dollar, a standard for measuring space, weight, time, etc. But where is the standard by which we are to measure human life? That is given by the Vaishnava. His behavior, his life, his characteristic. Vaishnavata. So that is the Vaishnava's behavior, his life, characteristic is known as Vaishnavata. That is the standard for everything. Once this is realized, then one must know where to look for such a standard bearer, a Vaishnava. By his or her standard, we can measure the quality of our own lives. We feel we have found such standard in the followers of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, like Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj Prabhupada, Srila Bhakti Sundar Govinda Dev Goswami Maharaj, who are in the line coming from Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, and Srila Bhakti Rakshak Srila Dev Goswami Maharaj. Srila Siddhar Maharaj, the founder Acharya of Sri Chaitanya Saraswati Math, better express his own qualification than we could in this regard. The quote from Srila Siddhar Maharaj that Maharaj has cited. The nature of my expressions of my presentation that was appreciated by my Guru Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, and also mostly by all the scholars in our math, because it is an ontological conception based on pure Chitvilas. That is, whatever I see, I have in view, that is, that it must cross the level of Brahmalok, not of this world, but of the other world, Chitvilas. That what the smallest thing that we mention here, every word, every syllable that I give out, it is from the plane of Visuddha Sattva. That is the special characteristics of my saying. So our so many stalwart acharyas, they appreciated my talks very much. They say it is very new, not a stereotyped thing. Whenever I give explanation to a particular sloka, every time some new thing is coming. Not any time, any mere repetition. Whether I say, whatever I say must have some touch with the infinite, that is peculiarity. So here Guru Maharaj is saying, every time what he says, something new is coming. And if you remember, Srila Sridhar Maharaj's Arati Kirtan, do you all remember? Srila Sridhar Maharaj's Arati Kirtan? Jay Guru Maharaj Jati Rajeshwar. Do you all remember that? Any of you? Jay Guru Maharaj Jati Rajeshwar being compiled, Arati Kirtan by our Gurudev, Om Vishnu Vasila Bhaktisundar Govindev Goswami Maharaj. There, one thing he mentioned about Sridhar Maharaj's quality, Ekatattva Varnanete Nitya Navabhav. To explain one concept, always some new mood is coming in explanation of, you know, Srila Sridhar Maharaj. That is the, you know, Sridhar Maharaj's real, you know, nature. That is the way Sridhar Maharaj, you know, is. So that Maharaj is explaining you. So to increase the faith, Shraddha, the basis, always of that, so that foundation, the faith that will be more consolidated. It, in this way, I am not partial or inimical to any person, not an enemy to anyone. In a general way, not referring to any particular section, in a most generalized way, I deal with things. And what is the standard of the absolute person by which the person of the Vaishnava is measured? Here, again, in the words of Srila Sridhar Maharaj, we find this most perfectly expressed. Only the full-fledged conception will be able to give full engagement of our inner tendency. It will provide the corresponding fear according to the need within us. Our heart, all rasa, all forms of ecstatic enjoyment must be within him, the center. The creation is not a very important function, but the corresponding engagement with the natural thirst of every atom is highest. He is the highest principle who can adjust everything in him, where all sorts of innate hankerings must be satisfied. That center should be perfect and the highest, who will be able to give satisfaction to all sorts of subtle demands within our nature, all corresponding relationships in every variegated way. All aspirations are accommodated there. That should be the prime cause. Reality is for itself. Everything is for him. It must have some utility in him. He is all accommodating, all pervading, all comprehensive, all fulfilling center. This should be the qualification of the absolute standard. Then Maharaj writes, we invite you to inquire further, read further, associate further, and thus nourish your soul for the joyful goal of human life, a life of love with the Lord of the heart through the search for Sri Krishna, the reality, the beautiful. So this wonderful explanation, this flyer that Sripad Puri Maharaj made for distribution of devotees. If you like, you can download it and edit it with the address and you can distribute that. If you like, it's a very important thing for devotees to know. They cannot judge their human life from their own standard or their own imagination, but to judge it from a standard given by a Vaishnava. What is the standard that Vaishnava has set? From there, we can, you know, read. We can, you know, judge ourselves. We can understand ourselves. Otherwise, it is not possible. So there is a nice article about, you know, some explanation on similar line that we can also read apart from that, you know, flyer, Guru Maharaj's article. This article is from Sermon of Guardian of Devotion, Volume 1, The Guardian Ruled Family. Chapter 11, we are reading from there, from Srila Sridhar Maharaj's explanation. The Vaishnava is all in all, and I am nothing. Such a feeling grows infinitely in Vaishnava. I am nothing, but he is everything. He is a Vaishnava. What is this? Chat is coming. Dandavat, Madan Mohan Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Maharaj, Dandavat Pranam.
Dandavat.
Jai Srila Gurudev.
How are you, Prabhu?
I'm good, Maharaj. Thank you.
Nice that you joined us. there is some problem with the Zoom some people are facing today. So begin little late, and I think some are getting dropped, or you know, hopefully the sound is coming.
Okay, sure, Maharaj.
The sound is coming okay, I think.
Yes, Maharaj.
Okay. We are reading from Guru Maharaj in this, you know, explanation. Siddhar Maharaj. The Vaishnav is all in all, and I am nothing. Such a feeling grows infinitely in Vaishnav. I am nothing, but he is everything. He is a Vaishnav Guru, and Vaishnav really hold Krishna Bhakti. They are the stockists, but I am empty handed. I have nothing. This is the nature of the association of the finite with the infinite. As much as we shall have a real approach towards the infinite, we cannot but consider ourselves to be meanest of the mean. The standard of Vaishnava qualification, Vaishnavata, is measured in this way. This is what Guru Maharaj is saying also. The standard of Vaishnava qualification, Vaishnavata, is measured in this way. And this is not lip deep, but the sincere dealing of innermost heart. When Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami says, Purusera kita haite muise laghishto, I am lower than the worm in the stool. This is not mere imitation, but his heartfelt truth. Acharya Abhiman, the assertion of the guru over his disciple, is different posture. That is assertion, but only for the service of the Vaishnava. The sincerity is maintained therein. The guru's assertion is not selfish assertion. His assertion is only for the sake of serving the public and upholding the prestige of the Vaishnava. So that is proper adjustment with reality in twofold senses, to establish the real position of a Vaishnava and at the same time to save the ordinary persons from the danger and the reaction of false attempt or false thought. So that kind of assertion is not egoistic. Rather, we should know that a sacrifice in dynamic sense. Do you all understand what Guru Maharaj is saying here? Madan Mohan Prabhu? Are you able to understand what Guru Maharaj is saying here?
Yes, Maharaj.
What so, understood?
Maharaj, here what Maharaj is, Guru Maharaj is emphasizing on the point that that how important and significant it is to approach the infinite for the finite soul, and how mean one has to be in terms of judging oneself in order to approach that infinite. How much self-negation attitude has to be cultivated and developed, so that we can then appreciate the relationship and approach from to the finite, to the infinite. Sorry.
Very nice. What is the meaning of self-negation? That word you used.
Self-negation means, Maharaj, that the attitude of having being in a state of servant of the servant of the servant.
Very nice.
That the ability given by the grace of Guru Gauranga is for the service, and this is infinitely small to approach the infinite.
Very nice.
Who is Krishna?
Very
and
nice.
that consciousness will only come by the mercy of Guru and Gaurang.
Yes.
I think, Maharaj, this is our Guru Maharaj is emphasizing here.
Yes, very nice, Prabhu. Actually, negation means we are for somebody. Instead of, you know, maintaining our own egoistic position, like the egoistic way the entities may exist, a grass may exist, but it is negated by other living entities like cow. Negated. For it become, you know, for cow now. What was existing for itself now become for cow. So we may exist thinking we are self, you know, what I can say, having self-purpose, our own purpose, we existing for our own purpose. But when our existence becomes for the purpose of the Absolute, that is self-negation. My whole existence is for Him, the way He wants to use it, what purpose He wants to use. Some of these things Sripad Puri Maharaj discussed in his recent book. You got the link, Madan Mohan Prabhu, for the book, Idols of the Mind?
No, Maharaj. Is it on our WhatsApp group, Maharaj?
Yes, on our WhatsApp group.
Sure, yes.
It is available on Amazon. Very recently it is being placed. You can get a copy.
Yes, Maharaj.
And you can read it about Hegelian philosophy. So, you want to read Madan Mohan Prabhu, the next paragraph?
Yes, Maharaj. Maharaj, from here, I'll read. Sure. In Vishwa Vaishnav Raj Sabha, or Guru Maharaj tactfully managed in this way, he asked one of his disciples to speak something in praise and appreciation of another disciple.
Do you know who is this Guru Maharaj? Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada.
Jai Shalom.
Okay. Siddhar Maharaj, okay. You know, Gurudev.
Okay, Maharaj. Okay, Maharaj.
Yes.
Jai Shalom Gurudev ki Jai. And he especially asked this disciple, who were a little antagonistic to another, he asked them, speak something in praise of your friend. Why? To try to mark the bright side, the Swarup, and to try to ignore the apparent side. He instructed, you try to speak something in praise of your friend, your apparent opponent. The Guru order was given, and so the disciple had to speak something in praise. Necessity is the mother of invention. He had to dive deep into the bright side of the other person and try to bring that side out. Thereby, the Vaishnav atmosphere of giving and taking was aroused, and the apparent mayic side was gradually ignored and disregarded and dissipated. And something similar happens in Kirtan as well. Why is Kirtan so powerful? Because when we are requested to speak something, we cannot but utilize our best attention to speak. We have to assert our best ability in the attempt to gather the proper information to speak something about the Supreme Lord. So, also in the case of Vaishnava, as in the case of Lord, we must approach the Swarupa, the inner side, the inner aspect, the bright side, and ignore the apparent side, and thereby we will thrive. There, the real mutual relationship will be aroused. Once a year in the holy dham of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, it was the practice of our Guru Maharaj to preside in a meeting under the banner of Vishwa Vaishnav Raj Sabha, Universal Assembly of the Topmost Pure Devotees. And there his method was such, try to praise the Vaishnava.
Do you understand here so clearly that Guru Maharaj is emphasizing the mood of Saraswati Thakur? When we come to the line of Vaishnavism, then we must honor other devotees. Don't see their defects. We are finite. We all have some defects. But don't see that. See the proper thing that they have, the sincerity, that their attitude to serve. Those things you have to see. And not to see, like a drain inspector, the other things. And when somebody is complaining about another devotee, then Prabhupada is saying, speak something about, good about your friend. Then he has to think. He never thought, what are the good qualities that devotee has? Then he has to think. And then he has to meditate on devotees qualities. That is the way one can make proper progress, seeing the proper things, not to see the unwanted things. So Madan, yes, what are you saying, Didi?
The meaning of antagonistic.
Yeah, you are, you know, trying to be unnecessarily too much looking into his, you know, defects, some kind of, you know, with grudge towards him. That's not good. We have to be, you know, more, what you can say, transcendental vision, like Narasingadev, seeing that Prahlad in previous life just sweeping the temple. He's not seeing he coming with a prostitute there. He's not seeing that. Adosu Darsi. So that vision has to, that vision has to be developed. Not just seeing the wrong things, not seeing the, you know, correct portion of that individual.
Like taking the positive things.
Yes. So we should not be antagonistic. Should not be keeping some, you know, grudge and, you know, trying to see, always trying to, you know, seeing him as an enemy and, you know, trying to, what you can say, minimize him. All those things, that type of attitude is not good. So, Madan Mohan Prabhu, do you want to continue reading?
Sure, Maharaj.
Okay, thank you, Prabhu.
So, to appreciate the nobility of a... Sorry, Maharaj. So to appreciate the nobility of a Vaishnava may be difficult, but if we can do so, we may have a chance to reach a standard of real devotion to a certain extent. It is said by the Lord in the Adi Purana, one who loves me does not really love me, but one who loves my servitors, his love for me is more real. It is true and of absolute character. We must try to appreciate the character and the conduct of the Vaishnava, and thereby we can raise the standard of our own life of dedication.
So
the infinite.
So here, one of the thing that, you know, is being told about, you know, one who loves me. Me means here Supreme Lord. He's not really loves me. Why is he saying like that? Why Lord is saying like that? Why saying like that? Anybody knows? Why Lord is saying like that?
Because Maharaj, this we do not have the ability to understand and fathom an infinite who is Krishna. So how can we love him?
What is the meaning of love? What is the meaning of love?
To dedicate the life, to dedicate love
means,
the life.
Love means you have to satisfy. Yes, Sumangla Didi, what do you want to say?
Serving.
Love means to satisfy some other person than yourself with all his, you know, desires, what he has. And then how a finite can ever, you know, do that? No, even just love that you are showing, that is some kind of, you know, your own interest is there. That's why you are doing that love. But the real love means, you know, that who individual who is satisfying that absolute, then I must assist there so that, you know, the infinite is satisfied the most. That is the true love. I love Prime Minister, I want to go and, you know, to him and disturb him. What is that law? You have to go to biomedia who knows what are the requirements of that, right? Then you can, you know, serve a king or, you know, whoever the person is. We don't have the real knowledge or ability even what are the requirements of that absolute. That is very important principle that here is, you know, explained. So let us continue reading.
Yes, Maharaj. The infinitesimal and the infinite are very closely connected. The consciousness of the infinitesimal in this is in this line. Ye yata patita haya tava daya tata taya tate ami Supatra Dayara Gita Mala Yamuna Bhavavali 19. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, "Your grace is given in accordance with the necessity of those who really deserve it. In that consideration, I have some claim. I am fallen of the fallen, the most fallen. So I have some claim to your grace." That should be the attitude of the servitor. Increase the negative side. I am the most deserving because I am meanest of the mean, poorest of the poor. We have to increase and develop our knowledge towards that side. I am so low, so needy, so mean in all respects that consciousness will draw him towards you. The mass energy collected, karma, or the attempt to know him, jnana, cannot do so. Jnana karmadi anavrittam. To think I can know you, I can measure you, that is impossible. Wild goose chasing, and this has been declared by Srimad Bhagavatam. You can never know him. The closer you come to the boundary of your knowledge, the more you will find him transcending it. No one can bind him. That was shown in the attempt of Mother Yashoda. When she went to bind Damodara, Krishna, around the waist, the rope was always two fingers short. Yad asat tad api nyunam tenanyada api sandhadhe tad api dveve angulam nyunam yad adata bandhanam. Srimad Bhagavatam 10.9.16. After joining the original rope with another, the rope was also short by the measure of two fingers. Then she tied more rope. That was also short by the same measure. In this way, no matter how much rope was she added, it was always short by two fingers. It is a mathematically impossible margin, but it is such. Similarly, we must know that the absolute is subjective, not objective. Examples
what
like
is the
this
meaning of subjective?
Depends on opinions of people, which could be different.
Yes. What do you mean by subjective? What you understood?
So I might interpret absolute to be subjective in one manner than another person, Maharaj. It's not objective. So the same way in which another person might interpret absolute will not be same. Means 2 plus 2 is equal to 4 for me, which is objective. Mm-hmm. But here it can be different for a different person. 2 plus 2 can be 4 for me, but for other person 2 plus 2 might be 5 or 6. So it's very subjective. How a person perceives absolute is subjective, is different from person to person. It's not objective.
When you say somebody is a subject, what is the meaning of that? That means that he has his own objects, isn't it? Without object, there is no subject exist. You understand? So absolute is subjective in the sense that he is not an object of our enjoyment. That we are subjects, and he has to be our object. Everything else is his object. He's a supreme subject, in fact. So people are thinking that, you know, some kind of fossil fatherism that Srila Sridhar Maharaj explained yesterday, we were reading, I think. There he's saying some, objects, that we are thinking is atoms, molecules. They grow into some, life and evolved and human. Then the God conception, manifested there in atoms and molecules. That is not. Actually, he is the subject and all other things are his objects. He is the being of all beings, actually. And he has his own purpose. for himself. He's for himself and also he's the cause of his own cause. So for himself indicates that he is a subject, as a purpose, right? Object that we are eliminating the subjective portion in object. That is the way, you know, the dominance. We are all eliminating there. Free will. But we cannot eliminate the will of the absolute. His will is supreme. You understand? We are using some animals, something for our work, driving the cart. We are not considering their will, what they want. We cannot do that with the absolute. His will is supreme. He has, you know, Sambit. You know the Sambit potency? You know Sambit? Anybody? Sambit, Sandini, Haladini. Three potency. What is the meaning of Sambit? Sambit means the will of the absolute. Is all powerful. You may will so many things, but only what absolute sanction that will come true. Man proposes, God disposes. Isn't it? That is the thing. In that way. Do you understand? We cannot understand absolute as an object, you know, that he has to be under the dictum of, you know, our, you know, what you can say, knowledge. It is not like that. What knowledge he will give to us, that much we can know about him. And he's always having some, you know, higher than what we can conceive of him. And that is the nature of infinite. Even supreme servitor, Radharani, she even thinking that I could not satisfy Krishna properly. Even I want to satisfy him properly. That is the nature of the absolute. Okay, let's continue reading, Prabhu.
Sure, Maharaj. Examples like this show us the failure of the objective calculation. Don't go to calculate the transcendental truth by the objective process. The factor of his will can never be eliminated. And that is the real factor. If you approach to calculate about him, the most realistic thought you must keep in your mind is that it depends on his supreme will. He is Abhigya, omniscient and Swarat, fully independent. Only he knows what is what and what should be what. It is his monopoly within his fist. You may conjecture so many alternatives but to no avail. He knows what he will do, and at the same time he is not under any obligation to anyone. He cannot be compelled to give any explanation for his deeds. Only he knows what is what, and he is the absolute autocrat. Arthasva Abhigya Swaraja Srimad Bhagavatam 111. He does not care for the consideration of others. If we approach him with his kind of understanding and impression, we must advance towards the divine realm.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Madan Man Prabhu. Who else can read? Sumangala Didi, do you want to read? Your mic is muted.
I have no possibility of pressing any demand on him. There is no possibility of placing any application. Please consider this or that. But at the same time, we must not forget that he listens only to the words of the devotee who is actually of such temperament. Aham Bhakta Prabhadhino.
Paradhino.
Yes, Srimad Bhagavatam.
Paradhino.
Okay. Aham Bhakta Paradhino.
You remember whom he told this sloka? We read some time back. You know Durvasa Muni, he was going to all the planets. He went to Narayan. Yes. Then Narayan told Durvasa, I am the slave of my devotee. And here Guru Maharaj says, we are saying absolute is completely independent. But yet he says, I am the slave of such a devotee who has completely given himself to me. Okay, let's read.
This also cannot be eliminated. But who is such a bhakta? One who knows the Lord's nature in this way. He is a devotee. So to become submissive to him is, in other words, to keep one's own independence. To be submissive to the surrendered soul amounts to no submission, because it is submit to a person who is fully his. When he says, I am subservient, I work under the direction of my devotee, then who are the devotees? They are those who have surrendered 10% to his sweet will. Then, in other words, they are as independent as he is. They do not have their independent wish, but nonetheless, for the sake of the Lord's pastime, Leela, such things are designed by Yogmaya in different rasas.
So can you all understand how by becoming surrendered, we are actually really gaining our freedom? Here Guru Maharaj explained. You understand? They are independent, Guru Maharaj says, as Lord. How? Anybody knows? Madan Mohan? Yes, Didi?
Now, because he is dependent on the sweet will of Lord, the devotees. That's why they are independent.
Anybody knows? Madan Mohan? How? How we are gaining our independence by surrendering to Lord?
By, if we become more and more submissive to the Lord, that is what is gaining one's own independence, Maharaj, by being submissive.
You know the law of karma? Law of karma? The law of karma is acted on those who are not surrendered. It brings them subjected to reactions. But the devotee is killing so many rice, Arjuna killing so many people. But no reaction is coming. Whatever they are doing, because they are doing for the interest of the Lord. Like a citizen in the country who is loyal to the interest of the country, he is killing for the interest of the country some people, still he is not subjected to law. Like the army man killing so many people, they are not subjected to law. They are free to do that because they are given their freedom for the country's interest. And such a free life can exist where whatever action one does, that is satisfying the Lord. It's a spontaneous way because of that loving platform. And love can give that. Out of love, one can even slap the Lord. Out of love, one can even give the remnant to Lord. Out of love, one can chastise Lord, like Mother Yashoda is doing, catching a stick and running behind. But an ordinary man does like that, then what will happen? What will happen? What will happen? There will be imposition of the law on that. So the freedom will come when you cultivate that proper surrender. Proper surrender, not only surrender, but beyond that is love. Love can make you do so many things. And Absolute is very happy with that. I was just meditating yesterday. I was thinking, sometime, we heard that, in Vrindavan Parikrama, that Lalita Devi is becoming very angry on Radharani. and chastising even her, saying, you don't know what is your good. You have to listen to me, what I say. You don't know that. You have to do what the way I say to you, you have to do like that. Very angrily she is saying. And, you know, that anger is not something of, you know, what you can say, offensive towards Radharani. But that is the expression of the love towards Radharani that, you know, Lalita Devi has. And the gopis, they are giving food dust to Krishna. Their own food dust. Can you imagine this? Your master, your lord, everything, and you are giving food dust to him. And yet, that is released by the Absolute. That is happily accepted by the Absolute. So that comes, that kind of, you know, things comes when the love has awakened. That love can give us that freedom. So that's why the Vaishnava is considered to be the standard. Madan Mohan Prabhu, you were not there. We were reading this, you know, flyer that our Shripad Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj prepared long back in, I think, early 90s for our Mutt, Sri Chaitanya Saraswat Mutt. You can note down this, you know, URL, and you can read about, you know, how Puri Maharaj explained about the Vaishnava is the standard of, you know, the human life. And Guru Maharaj also given some explanation about that here. How the Vaishnava can lead us to, you know, a platform of, you know, spontaneity, our true freedom. Human life is, human society is running for freedom, right? They are freedom fighters. They fought for freedom. But what is the freedom? What is the freedom? Are we getting freedom? Do we have real freedom? We fought and we got some independence, we say, but have we got that freedom? Have we got it? We want to have happiness, but unhappiness is coming. If we are doing something, eating something, then, you know, some reaction is coming. The air is not cooperating. The fire is not cooperating. Environment is not cooperating. Where is freedom there? And Srila Guru Maharaj told, there is at another world where everything is, you know, cooperating for one center. Here are so many centers. Everybody wants to become absolute here. That type of conception Vaishnava is not practicing. Vaishnava is practicing the conception of, you know, absolute centerism. Everything centered around absolute. He is accepting everything as the wish of the absolute. Then Prahlad Maharaj is being attacked by his father. Prahlad Maharaj never protested. Even Haridas Thakur, he never protested. Even he was praying for their good, Haridas, telling, oh Lord, nothing should happen to these Jalads who are beating me. Saying like that. Even Amrish Maharaj was like this. That type of, when the love has awakened, when real love has been awakened, then this type of, you know, mood of, you know, what you can say, dedication will manifest. So that we wanted to discuss today. If there is any other questions or comments, they are most welcome before we conclude.
Hare Krishna, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna. Dhanyavad, Madan Mohan.
Maharaj, two requests. One is, if you can please share the link for the flyer.
Again? I will send it to you on WhatsApp. Sure, let me see on chat. Do you want me to send you now on chat?
Yes, Maharaj. Both will do. WhatsApp or chat.
Let me send you to chat.
Thank you, Maharaj.
You save it, otherwise the chat may get deleted.
Sure. Any other? Second one is,
yes.
The second one is, Maharaj, little outside the today's subject. So can,
yes,
I ask?
Yes, 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 Prabhu.
Okay, Maharaj. Thank you, Maharaj. Maharaj, this is regarding the Guru Maharaj, our Acharya's, Achardev's session yesterday, Zoom session yesterday.
Yes.
So Maharaj, you asked him a question regarding regarding the Gopal.
Yeah. Yes.
Yes, Maharaj. I could understand your question.
Gopal Guru.
Yes, Maharaj. Gopal Guru. Yes. I could understand the question. What question you were asking, and yes. Maharaj reply.
Yes.
But Maharaj, can you spend a minute or two, Maharaj? What is Gopal Guru?
Oh, actually, this Gopal was a devotee staying at the same place near Gomira. There is deity, I think, Radhakanta deities are there. So he was worshipping that deity there. And actually, Mahaprabhu, if you go to Gombira, this deity is just beside Gombira, actually. That house of where Mahaprabhu was staying in Jagannath Puri. So Mahaprabhu was going to washroom and he's putting his tongue like this. And what has happened? Why, Mahaprabhu is doing like this? And he's coming, Prabhu, what happened? You have some problem? Health is okay? Then he's saying that, oh, Gopal, you know my tongue become very naughty. It is constantly chanting the holy name. Even I'm going to the washroom and it is not stopping. Then, Prabhu, you only told us that we should always chant the holy name. There is no consideration of time, place, circumstances. And now, if we are fallen soul, we are Baddha Jivas, if we die in the washroom, and what will happen if we don't chant the Lord's name and we will die like that? Then says, Gopal, you have given the right conception. Holy name can be chanted everywhere, even in washroom. From today, because you've given the proper conception to me, from today, you are Gopal Guru. You have given me the proper conception and everybody must also understand it. In this way, Mahaprabhu given that recognition actually. So to give proper recognition to the devotee who is giving the proper conception is the nature of Mahaprabhu and his followers. We don't collect recognition for ourselves, but we should always be ready to give recognition from any corner that may be received, even from a blade of grass. We are not discriminating anything. As we see, even Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami saying that a worm in the stool, I am lower than that. That means a worm in the stool has some higher quality. He's seeing in that worm in the stool. That is devotee. That is the genuine nature of a devotee. A genuine Vaishnav can see such thing. He cannot see himself superior. He cannot. That is the nature of the absolute. When one is advancing towards absolute, then he can recognize his insignificance. And in that mood of humility, he can see, others' glory, others' greatness. Appreciate the divinity in that, other individual. Like Saraswati Thakur was saying here, you are only seeing the wrong things, but you are not seeing the good things in that devotee. So, yesterday my point is this. Mahaprabhu, when he heard this from Gopal Guru, immediately he recognized and told, given that recognition to him. Similarly, if we are, getting some proper conception from an individual, and then we are, seeing it worthy and in line with our Guru Parampara, this type of conception, then we must give that, and refer that. We not just use that for our own glory, as if that is our message. That is not our message. Krishna has given that revelation to that individual, that soul. And we have to give that recognition. Like Mahaprabhu even told, Sridhar Kripaye Bhagavat Jani. By the grace of Sridhar Swami, I know Bhagavatam. I tell that to that proud Pandit. His name was, I think, Vallabh Bhatta. Who later on asked forgiveness anyway. That Vallabha Sampradaya is there in Gujarat, who worship Laddu Gopal. He was telling, I have a greater, better commentary than Sridhar Swami. Mahaprabhu saying, I know Bhagavatam by Sridhar Swami and you are thinking you are greater than Sridhar. You are not accepting your master, then you are a prostitute. Mahaprabhu told that to him. Like that. So we have to learn to give proper honor and recognition to those Vaishnavas who are giving us proper conception. It's not just sentimental mission. Mahaprabhu's mission is not sentimental mission. Mahaprabhu's mission is for highest theistic intelligence person, those who have highest theistic intelligence. You know that verse from Bhagavatam? Krishna Varnam Trisakrishnam Sangapangastra Parsadam Jagyai Sankirtan Payeri Ajantihi Sumedasa. You know this sloka, Madan Mohan Prabhu?
No, Maharaj.
Krishna Varnam Trisakrishnam, you don't know?
Sorry, Maharaj. No.
Is the sloka. That is the reference of Mahaprabhu's appearance. Is there. So that we have to, you know, very much, that there is Sumedasa is there. Sumedasa. Sumedasa means highest theistic intelligence. That's what Srila Sridhar Maharaj translated in that way. Highest theistic intelligence. Those who don't have highest theistic intelligence, then they cannot appreciate Mahaprabhu's mood, Mahaprabhu's mood of, you know, what you can say, understanding things. Highest theistic intelligence is necessary. Highest theistic intelligence, Buddhi Yoga. Srila Guru Maharaj told this is, we need Buddhi Yoga. We don't have Buddhi Yoga. Then, you know, you cannot, what you can say, understand what Absolute want. What is the need of Absolute? What, how can please Absolute? That you cannot get it there. So it's very, very important, you know, thing, these all, you know, things. It's not some, you know, superficial thing. So let us read this sloka from Srimad Bhagavatam. Let me see if I can find it for all of you. Okay. Where is this verse? Okay. Okay, I bought it. Here. Krishna Varnam Trisakrishnam Sangapangastra Parsadam Jagyai Sankirtan Prayir Yajantihi Sumedasa. Srimad Bhagavatam 11.5.32. In the age of Kali, intelligent persons perform congregational chanting to worship the incarnation of Godhead, who constantly sings the name of Krishna. Although his complexion is not blackish, he is Krishna himself, and he is accompanied by his associates, servants, weapons, and confidential companions. So here, that intelligence word is not being, you know, given, I think, clearly in the translation. But here, if you see, Sumedasa is intelligent person. See, and Srila Sridhar Maharaj explained it as, you know, highest theistic intelligence. Sridhar Maharaj told that as highest theistic intelligence. So Mahaprabhu's mission is not for, you know, sentimentalists. Those who think that, you know, just mere sentiment of receiving initiation and finished, for them it is not enough. They have to learn these things by proper association. Realized souls. They have to learn all these things and practice that, implement that in their life, day-to-day life. That is necessary. Srila Prabhupada sometimes used to criticize to his grandfathers, A.C. Bhaktivinoda and Prabhupada. Say, oh, you people are only ringing the bells in the temples. You people are only ringing the bells in the temple. And he used to, very much driven by mood of his Guru Maharaj, Saraswati Thakur. And Saraswati Thakur was of that mood that even he wanted to cook meat in London, in the hostel. If the students of London, they don't want to stay without eating meat, they are so addicted, then I can cook meat for them. But they have to listen what I'm saying. You want to go even that extent. that type of mood. But they have to listen to me. They have to listen and learn these things properly. So, Nityananda Prabhu, he's not so much philosophical. He gives a good foundation. He gives us faith. But further higher understanding comes when we come to the line of, you know, Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu is more philosophically understanding things, no? He discussed all this philosophy with Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, with Prakashananda Saraswati, and not only that, with Raya Ramananda. All these conclusions, he discussed that. But Nityananda Prabhu is simply distributing, and he opened so many Namhattas. So many Namhattas. So Srila Sridhar Maharaj is of that nature. Deep meditation of these inner things. And I also feel that type of mood with Sripad Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj. He has, you know, what he can say, very deeply meditated about these all, you know, things. And, you know, we are just telling those things superficially, but he has the realization of all these things from Guru Maharaj. That Srila Sridhar Maharaj used to say many times to him, "I am like you. I am like you," he used to say. Then Puri Maharaj was not able to understand why Sridhar Maharaj is saying like that, "I am like you." Then he asked his secretary, and "Please ask Guru Maharaj why he says to me like this." Then he asked Guru Sridhar Maharaj. Then he told, that means, its meaning is that he has been accepted. To enter into the that devotee camp of Mahaprabhu, you need acceptance. You need acceptance there, and all understanding, all dynamics, then you will know there. Without acceptance, you cannot. It cannot enter it aggressively by poking your nose there. It is not going to happen like that. Yeah, you cannot. Entrance has to be given when proper mood has been, you know, cultivated, proper attitude has been developed. Then that entrance is, you know, given. Is not happened by force. You cannot go there. So we have to give that recognition to the devotees, those who are carrying that type of conception. Without that, we are only becoming sahajya. You know what is sahajya? Anybody knows what is sahajyaism? Madan Mohan, do you know what is sahajyaism?
No, Maharaj, not exactly.
Sahajayajam means?
I have heard about it.
Yes. Sahajayajam means just telling the, you know, listening from a devotee and seeing the devotee's behavior, and you are imitating that without having any substantial grasp or realization of those things. That is Sahajayajam. A devotee is crying, I am crying in the public to get some, you know, popularity. Devotee is, you know, rotating round, and I am also rotating round to get some popularity. Or devotee has told these things and I am just repeating that so that I will gain some popularity. But I have not grasped those things. I have not realized.
Copying.
Yes. Imitation. Imitation. Sahajayajam is imitation. Prakruta. Prakruta ras. We are trying to imitate a prakrita. In a prakruta way. Is out. That is what sahajayajam. That's why Saraswati Thakur written a critique of, you know, the sahajayajam. Prakruta rasa sata dhusani. That book Saraswati Thakur has. Prakruta rasa sata dhusani. The 100 defects of that, you know, prakruta rasa. You have not realized those things of a prakruta, and you are trying to imitate, not giving that honor to those devotees who brought that wealth to this world. So whenever you are hearing all this conception from a devotee, from a Vaishnava, or reading his book or anything, then you must recognize that devotee, give that honor to that devotee. And from that devotee's grace, I am receiving these things. Then that is proper mood. By the grace of that devotee, you can understand those things. Krishna has given that wealth to the heart of that devotee, not to take credit for yourself. Then you will be condemned, actually, if you do that. You will never get access to that plane. You will never get. You cannot steal. You have to come with begging. Come with begging. Give proper honor to that. And devotee can give by glorifying devotees. By devotee's grace, you may get something of that, his realization, what he has. You cannot steal it. I was also telling in that about a person who got some books of Goswami's being stolen by the Birhambir king. And some person was reading those books and telling those things without even having any realization of those things. And Srinivas could see, oh, these things I heard, I seen, this is my guru's thing. Who is saying this thing without a wrong way, incorrect way? Then he found out from Birhambir this, all these things. Oh, you have stolen all these books. And yes, from there, these all things are coming like this. So giving proper recognition, proper honor to the Vaishnavas who are giving those things is the most important quality. And Mahaprabhu followed that and the devotees always followed that. So that was my point yesterday. Understand, Madan Mohan Prabhu?
Yes, Maharaj. Thank you so much.
Yes. Any other points or anything anybody wants to discuss? Okay. So if there is nothing else to discuss, then we are going to end our sangha here. Bancha kalpataru vasya kripa sindhu bhaya vacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo nama namaha. Jayam Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribraj Kacha Javadguru Srila Bhakti Damodar Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai. Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribraj Kacha Javadguru Srila Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj Ki Jai. Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribraj Kacha Javadguru Srila Bhakti Nirmalacharya Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai. Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribraj Kacha Javadguru Srila Bhakti Sundar Govinda Dev Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai. Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribraj Kacha Javadguru Srila H. Bhaktan Sen Prabhupaji Maharaj Ki Jai. Jayam Vishnupad Paramahansa Paribraj Kacha Javadguru Srila Bhakti Raksha Sayadav Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai. Bhagavan Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sastaku Prabhupaji Maharaj Ki Jai. Mahabhagavat Srila Gorkhasadas Babaji Maharaj Ki Jai. Satchitananda Bhakti Vinod Thakur Ki Jai. Vaishnava Sarvam Jagannath Babaji Maharaj Ki Jai. Baladev Vidyavasan Prabhu Ki Jai. Narottam Das Thakur Ki Jai. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai. Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasai Ki Jai. Rupanuga Guru Varga Ki Jai. Ramacharya Haridas Thakur Ki Jai. Prem Sagala Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Shivas Adi Sri Gaur Bhaktavinda Ki Jai. Sarva Damodar Raimanda Adi Bhaktavinda Ki Jai. Murari Gupta Prabhu Ki Jai. Saparsada Nityananda Prabhu Ki Jai. Saparsada Mahaprabhu Ki Jai. Bhakti Devi Vrinda Devi Ki Jai. Ganga Devi Jamuna Devi Ki Jai. Grantharas Srimad Bhagavatam Ki Jai. Chaitanya Charitamrita Chaitanya Bhagavat Ki Jai. Bhaktiraj Prahlad Maharaj Ki Jai. Suddha Bhakti Vigna Vinashan Bhagavan Narasimha Dev Ki Jai. Jai Shri Jagannath Baladev Subhadra Sudarshan Jiv Ki Jai. Jagannath Puri Dham Ki Jai. Mayapur Navadvip Dham Ki Jai. Aparaj Bhanjan Parsi Kuladip Ki Jai. Jai Shri Gupta Govardhan Ki Jai. Jai Shri Sadashiv Gangadhar Jiv Ki Jai. Jai Shri Mathura Vrindavan Dham Ki Jai. Jai Shri Shyamakund Radhakund Giri Govardhan Ki Jai. Jai Shri Chaitanya Sarasvat Math Ki Jai. तद्य विश्वव्यापी शाखा समूह की जाए, तद्य विश्वव्यापी सेवक वृंद वैष्णव वृंद की जाए, श्री चैतन्य सरस्वती इंस्टीट्यूट की जाए, प्रिंसटन भक्ति वेदांत इंस्टीट्यूट की जाए, जय समवेद भक्तवृंद की जाए, जय मदन मोहन प्रभु की जाए, सत्य सुंदरी दीदी की जाए, जय सदा सदा शिव व्हाट इज द प्रभुस नेम सदानंद ईश्वरानंद ईश्वरानंद जय श्रीपाद ईश्वरानंद प्रभु की जय सुमंगला दीदी की जय एंड दैट व्हाट इज द नेम रेडमी दैट आई फॉरगॉट योर नेम
अर्पिता
दीदी की जय सो थैंक यू फॉर जॉइनिंग अस एंड वी आर हैविंग आवर संगा यू आर यू मेंबर ऑफ आवर व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप सर्वेंट ऑफ गुरु वैष्णव आर यू देयर
या
ओके यू कैन रिसीव द मैसेजेस देयर every day around 5 o'clock or order of that time we do the sangha india time you're most welcome to join joy khol kartal ki joy harinam sankirtan ki joy nitai gaur premanande hari hari bol dandavat everyone
shripad bhakti nishkam shant maharaj ki jai
jai gurudev dandavat everyone please stay well take care we meet again dandavat Sumangala Didi, if you have time, I want to speak something to you. we can talk on Skype or something after the Sangha.
Yes,
okay, Dandavat. What is that? Yeah, it will start. Krishna Kesava Prabhu will start soon. You can join through Skype. Dandavat. Huh?